Hello everyone! The big new Norwegian horror release of 2019 is a remake of our very first horror film, Lake of the Dead, from 1958. This film has its premiere on November 1st, but I was lucky enough to recently catch it at its very first public screening at the Ramaskrik Film Festival. I am Torstein from Cinema Terror, and this is the 2019 version of the Dødes Tjern, or as it will be known by internationally, Lake of Death. If you've seen the original, then I can tell you right from the start that this one strays purposely away from retelling the same story. Lake of Death takes the setting and the, well, lake, but changes pretty much everything else to update and modernize it. We still get a group of friends going to a cabin with a lake by it, but this time they're all there to support a young woman named Lillian. She spent her childhood at this place together with her twin brother Bjørn, and now she's returning to the cabin to say goodbye to the place on the 1 year anniversary of her brother's mysterious death, as she has decided to sell it to be able to move on. She has brought along her closest friends, and they quickly get settled in for a fun weekend away from modern civilization. But their fun gets interrupted when strange things start to take place at the cabin. The group is unsure if one of them is messing around with the rest, or if this is caused by someone else, perhaps even a supernatural entity. With no ways of getting away from this place, the young adults have to figure out what is going on and try to make it out of there alive before they all end up deep in the water of the Lake of Death.
Jeg har bare hørt at det liksom at det skal være noe med det kjernen her.
Dem som sank til bunns, de vil leve for evigt.
I wish I could come on here and say that this new one is as great and fun as the original, but sadly I cannot. Lake of Death 2019 is a film that I felt like I had seen countless of times before. It has a horror movie premise, but attempts to go for the psychological horror route without succeeding getting me engaged or interested in where the story was going. It all felt way too familiar, and there isn't anything new in the way it is presented either to make it enjoyable. The film lacks any type of tension and fails to take advantage of the Norwegian woods that can be quite frightening at nighttime. I should know, as I live 10-15 minutes away from where parts of this was shot. They spend more time inside the cabin, a dull looking location that we've seen too many times before, and it makes sure to remind you of that as they deliver several obvious references to other horror films that are played out in the same type of setting. I didn't care about a single character in the film, including the leading lady Lillian, played by Iben Akli. She's a beautiful woman and has a warm aura around her that makes her perfect as the main character in a horror film, but she gets way too little to work with there. She walks around most of the time in the same confused state, and she didn't leave enough of an impression to make me care for her. There are some late plot twists introduced, but since Lillian had gained little interest by me at that point, all the twists and turns came off inefficient on me.
Where are you at?
Svar meg, din heks! Hva
det der sker?
Hjelp! Hjelp! Jeg slipper ikke unna.
I also thought the rest of the characters were uninteresting and stereotypical. There's a comic relief guy, a hot blonde, a love interest for Lillian, and so on. With poor dialogue and cliché characters, none of these actors managed to add much enjoyment to the experience. The creator behind Lake of Death is Ninni Bull Robsam, who both wrote and directed the film. She has experience within the genre, as she also worked as a writer on the 2008 film Manhunt, another one that I found to be underwhelming. Both Robsam and the star Iben Akeli were present at the screening I went to, and both came off as kind, likable creators, so even if this one didn't work for me, I do hope that the movie will provide them with success and praise from others. As mentioned earlier in this video, Lake of Death will have its wide release in cinemas here in Norway on the 1st of November. I have no idea if it will be screened outside of the Nordic countries, but for those who want to check it out, I can let you know that it will be coming soon to the awesome streaming service Shudder in America, the UK, Canada, Ireland, Australia and New Zealand. I wish I could recommend this film, but I have to be honest and say it felt flat on me. There's not much for me to enjoy here, except looking at Akeli for 95 minutes. It might fit better for fans of Scandinavian thrillers than for horror fans, and I think this one will come and go quite quickly. Lake of Death was a disappointment and only gets a 2 out of 5. Will you be checking out Lake of Death? And have you seen the original from 1958? I liked that one quite a bit, and I did do a video review for it 2 years ago, and there should be a link popping up on your screen for it any second now. I hope you enjoyed this review, and if you did, then make sure to like and subscribe and all of that stuff. There are plenty of other videos to be found on my channel, and plenty more to come here on Cinema Terror. Thank you for watching.